I'm staring at a headline here. Kevin McCarthy sets vote to recall Liz Cheney as GOP conference chair. Obviously, Liz Cheney's made a bunch of headlines, all the endless anti-Trump babble. That doesn't really matter. My point is, has always been with this Liz Cheney thing, the party is remaking itself. We're dumping the old spineless people who don't want to fight, and we're bringing in new blood, Lord willing, people such as yourself. I don't think this is a world-ending thing. I think it's the natural course of things when it comes to parties. Parties remake themselves. The GOP needed it, and that's what's happening. Or am I missing something?
No, you're 100% correct. It's interesting because after I lost my first election in November of last year, I actually received a message from someone that told me that I was on the wrong side of history and that if I ever aligned myself with President Trump or the American First ideologies, that I would never make it in Washington, D.C. And I actually argued, for one, that's completely wrong. What we're seeing right now is the only reason we're having such a strong push for different Republican candidates is because the American people realize that those in Washington, D.C., those special interests, bureaucrats that have no interest in really representing the American people, instead they want to represent corporations and essentially China, that's not the best fit for us, so that people like myself and other candidates around the country need to be elected in order to represent those American people. And you are seeing a rebranding, not just of the Republican Party, but I think also too nationally of the younger conservative generation taking over in this handover that's really taking place with the old guard and the new guard coming in. So I'm really hopeful to be a part of that. And actually, that's why I'm now a congressional candidate again.
And I do have to challenge you on something. Why do you want to go to D.C.? D.C. sucks. You're in Florida. You should be on a beach eating shrimp dip and drinking Mai Tais somewhere. Why do you want to go to D.C.?
Well, I do that sometimes, but I realize that, you know, the problem is, especially for the Hispanic American demographic, and a lot of people look at me sometimes, they assume that, you know, I might just be white, but I'm actually half Mexican. And so because of that, I realized that in 2020, the largest voting minority are Hispanic Americans, but that there's no one representing our communities at the national level. And because of that, you have the Democrat platform that's really targeting the largest voting minority in U.S. history. And then you have media in addition to that, whether it's Telemundo or Univision, that are absolutely brainwashing the Hispanic American demographic into thinking that Republicans and the conservative platform is a quote-unquote racist and xenophobic and anti-immigrant ideology. And we know that that's false. And so what I realized is, and of course, you know, I've been offered jobs in media, and the reason why I didn't do that, although I would have loved to, and I'm not ever closing that door, but the reason why I'm not doing that right now is I feel like that's putting the cart before the horse. And if you have someone like myself or others like me, like I know Catalina Lauf is running against Adam Kinzinger in Illinois, but people like us that can target and speak to our communities, that gives hope for people. That makes them realize that maybe they were lied to. And so I'm hoping to impact the national discussion, and that's why I'm running for office.
Hey, thanks so much for watching The First on YouTube. If you liked what you saw, go ahead and like and subscribe. You heard me, like it, subscribe. You'll get a lot more of it and a lot more of me. Thanks.